The blues is many things. The blues is telling a story. The blues is a feeling. The blues is a philosophy. The blues is a set of changes. But one thing that defines the blues is the blue notes. And I want to show you when you solo or when somebody else solos over the blues, they typically use a scale called the blues scale. Now let's say we have a blues in E. You are going to be playing the major pentatonic as your source material. The soloist will use a scale that's called the blues scale that uses a bunch of notes that are called the so-called blue notes. One note that is in that scale is the minor third. The blues scale is derived from the minor pentatonic. So the minor pentatonic obviously being the root flat 3, 4, 5, flat 7, there's another blue note, and then on top the root. So you have this rub of the chords and the bass player who's down there outlining the major pentatonic, where the major is the third is major, and you have that rub with that minor third, the so-called blue note, in the soloist. So when you are soloing as a bass player, you can totally use the minor pentatonic to blow over the blues changes. There are three blue notes. The flat third, as I just mentioned, creating this beautiful rub with the major third in the chords and in the walking or accompanying bass. So the major, the minor third is one blue note. The other blue note is the flat five. And that's a note that's not in our minor pentatonic, but we're going to stick it in there, and then we're going to call the minor pentatonic the blues scale. So, flat 5, and then the flat 7, which is of course part of my minor pentatonic anyway. It's not part of the major pentatonic, but it's part of the minor pentatonic, and again creates this nice rub with what the rest of the rhythm section is playing. So, even though the chord is E7, I get to play the minor pentatonic over it as I solo. And not just the minor pentatonic, but the so-called blues scale, which is nothing but the minor pentatonic with that added flat 5. So you have in your handouts two positions in the patterns where this flat 5 lies really well. There are a lot of patterns where they don't, where the flat 5 doesn't fit into the position. So it is pattern 3 and pattern 6 where you can very easily finger that flat 5. So once again, the blues scale creates a rub with what the chords are doing, what the bass player is doing down on the bottom. The blues scale typically used by the soloist. And here's the nice thing about the blues scale. When you have a blues in E, let's say the blues is in E7 and then changes to A7 and goes back to E and then goes to B7, goes back to A7, back to E7. Even though the chords are changing, I can keep the same blues scale going through the whole set of changes. And typically a solo of a blues goes something like this. Well, I woke up this morning and my baby was gone. And then, you know, you have a little bit of pause to digest that news. And then you want to repeat that because it's so heart-wrenching, you want to say it again. But while you do that, the chord underneath changes. And even so, even though I might play the same phrase, the chord changing underneath makes it sound fresh. And then it goes back to, you know, just waiting and feeling the gut-wrenching effects of what I just expressed musically, and then you have four more bars to sort of tie it up and tie it back together and put garnish on it, and that's then the end of it. So that's kind of like a very basic idea of thinking about a blues scale, but it's a very good concept to think about in terms of all solos, because it forces you to think about doing rests, letting the music breathe, making a statement, which are all good things for a solo. That make a solo good and interesting. Let me give you an example of soloing over a E7 blues using the blues scale throughout, not changing with the chord changes.
Mm-hmm.
it. I'm going to say that again and make sure you heard me. And then I'm going to tie it up somehow. So this is just one example of what you can do as a soloist when you are playing over blues changes. Keep the same scale, pick the pentatonic, the minor pentatonic with the added flat five, which is called the blues scale, and blow that over all the changes, ignoring the fact that they go from 1 to 4 and 5 and all that sort of thing. It creates a very bluesy feel, and it sounds great over solos. However, if you are the bass player, having the bass duty down there, holding down the groove, then you have to play the major third, and it's good to use pentatonic, major pentatonic material.